Welcome to Analytics with Nax. This is another video in the Catch Up with Nax series where I'm going to talk about create reports directly in Power BI services. Yes, you heard it right. We can directly create reports in Power BI services provided that certain limitation. That's what we're going to discuss in this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. So things to consider, like there is no modeling. You cannot do any modeling for your data. If you have multiple tables, this will not work out as of now. And you can see here, like only single table or fat model. So if you have multiple tables as a star schema, this will not work out as of now. What you can do is you can combine all the data into a single table and you can make it as a fat model. Then you can be able to do enter or copy paste. There are two ways currently. Either you can enter the data or copy paste from the table. Otherwise, one last option you will have is like you already published your Power BI reports as a data sets, right? Once you publish your Power BI report, it will be splitted into reports and data set. So already published data set, you can create a new report. So this is what all about things you need to consider. So why I'm taking this topic is like while searching on internet, whether is there any online portal or any other tool that creates a report on the internet when we provide our user data. While searching it, I came across like in Power BI itself, we can do it, right? So why can't we take it as one video? That is why I have taken this topic today. Let's try to check it out how it happens. So we are in Power BI. So in Power BI service actually. So how you can create, go to create here. And you can see here, as I said before, there are two options, paste or manually enter the data. Otherwise, you can pick it from the published data set. When you click on it, you can see all these reports I have published before. I have published to the service. Either you can pick it up from there and then you can start working on it. But this is not our focus. Our main focus is like anyone having their own data, any user without downloading Power BI desktop, they can create on their own. Assume they're not at all familiar with their Power BI desktop or any reporting concept, right? They want to create the report on internet. So once they log into Power BI, then they can choose this option. And I am going to use the Excel, that is Naga Garments data. I will copy this data. Instead of entering, I will copy it, okay? I mean, copy and paste. I pasted it here and they need to choose this option, use first row as header, that's it. There is no further transformations required. So just once you create it, there are options available. Create a blank report, create a data set only, or auto create report. Let's go for auto create report and see how it works. So this is what I meant. Like once a user logs in, he pastes his own data, and Power BI services itself, that will create a report on its own. How beautiful it is. That is what I thought of informing you. So you can see here, now it has some GUI. It has created reports, everything based on the date column. Now I want to customize this. Instead of this, I don't want axis to be part of year. I will go for category name and I will remove this a field as well. So category wise I want to view and I will go for a donut chart. So this is how you can change it. Even here I will customize this again. I don't want this. I want something like pie chart, and here I will use only by month, only by year, and I can use the small multiples, whatever the latest will be available, location wise small multiples. So this is how end user who is not at all aware of anything about Power BI or any thing. He doesn't want to know any logics about some calculations, right? So he can do a simple report quickly in 5 minutes. How beautiful it is the Power BI has made. As of now, we have only a flat model, and sooner or later, people or Microsoft people will get into uploading Excel as well directly into Power BI services. So this future, I thought of informing you. So that is why I made this video. Now you can see you can change the sum to count, average. So it is very simple as that. Everyone will be easily understand how they need to use it. Once you are done, you can save this report, save it as online report demo. That's it. You can save it. So this will be stored as another report in the Power BI services. I hope you like this video. You understand the concept behind it, like how you can quickly create the reports online. This will be useful when you want to do a demo and you do not have a desktop downloaded. You just copy and paste and prepare the reports quickly as possible.